Thank you. Hello, good evening. I just noticed I should have turned my microphone on at least. Good evening and welcome again. As the title already suggests, I'm going to try for a small trip to Luna. This is just a prelude. To put it like this, I was testing around different configurations and so on with the technology I have available. And since I am still lacking the mainsail engine, I have to go with the skipper. And the skipper has roughly less than half the thrust than the mainsail has. So I have not yet completed the vehicle I want to send over there. I made one version of the lander. And after sleeping one night over it, I was was rethinking my approach. I was adding these 400 tanks, and the problem is I want to go two times to Duna. And you see the problem. If I drop these, I'm missing out on the extra Delta V they provide. So in the end, I had to scratch this and added a 16 tank underneath the inline wheel. Version 2, version 2. Could be this one. Final, final. I named it final. Final 2. Okay, there we go. Yeah, that's it. Okay, it's practically the same. Nothing changed except that I removed the radial tanks and the radial stage or slash asparagus stage and added this. Oh, it's an 8 fuel tank. This is the 16. I added this 8 fuel tank, which roughly gives me the same amount of Delta V as the 16 one. Regarding the Delta V map, I have I basically need like 1 point. Where is it? One or roughly 1450 Delta V to reach a 60 km orbit. There are different influence factors, of course. Sorry, I had to take a sip from my tea. There are different influencing factors, mainly the height of the terrain. I must admit, because you will not land on some 0 meter area. You will usually drop down on some higher ground. And I hope I am able to drop down in a biome area which has quite near adjusted areas, so I like have to walk less than 1 kilometer with my Kerbal to get a surface sample or to do some crew report, whatever. We will see. Okay, this is the lander part. What I'm still missing is some kind of hopper. I want a small vehicle that can go to Ike, the moon of Duna, and back to the orbit around Duna, where the main ship or the main stage will be in orbit. Yeah, I did some testing. Not with a mini lander or the like, nothing like that at all. Since last time I played in the stream, over this week and at, yeah, in the evenings, I did like 1 hour testing different configurations of engines and asparagus stagings and so on. This will be, or this is more or less the result of my testing. Just a moment, I have to check which file I saved last. Let's see. Saves. Stream. Chips. Two. Duna XL2D. Duna XL2D. Ah, there we go. For 240 parts and yeah. Okay. any questions? Yeah, this is my Duna ship. I hope you are able to partly read the small numbers down here. Okay, let's take this step by step. So I have this tank with Probodyne, with a Probodobodyne. What a name, Octo, but I like it. Octo 2, it's small, flat, and capable. I love it. I also added two solar panels to each side one. And this is basically the dummy payload. I will use the part after or with the stack separator. This will be my sub-assembly. I will move it then here in the sub-assembly area and save it. But this is only for testing. Everything now you see here is for testing. So what do we have here? A lot and a lot of engines. Since I'm yeah, I will take this apart a little bit just to show what's going on here. This is all asparagus staging. As most of you have heard of it, or at least heard the name, it means basically you go and burn the fuel out of a tank that's used. And you have the dead weight of the tank, and if you have stacked it like this, there's an orange tank and there's an orange tank, and this tank is empty and this is still full. You still have the empty tank, and the empty tank isn't weightless, it has a lot of weight. So the deal is also if engine is attached to it, the deal is you drop all the dead weight and you have these fuel lines. These are critical. Without the fuel lines, you're not able to do the asparagus staging. These fuel lines pump all the fuel out of the last tank, or the lower stage in this case. This is number 13. There you go. As soon as this is dry, it's dropped. There's a counterpart on the other side there. I do this in pairs, and usually 3x3. Three by three. One, two, three, one, two, three, and it's mirrored. So double, so six. As I already mentioned, you have these fuel lines, and as you might make out now, there are these arrows pointing in the direction of the fuel flow. It means you first attach it here on this tank, where you want the fuel out, and then you attach it to the tank you want the fuel pumped inside or into. And so on and so on and so on. So in my case, just concentrate on this part. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. It goes like a snail. It goes like a snail symbol or whatever. Out from here, in 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 here, and drop. I hope you got it. So this means basically I have two. If you put it just as simple as it is, I have just two big fuel pumps on each side of the main engine, and they are pumping fuel out of all these tanks. As you see, I attached some of these 8 tanks. I had to watch out for different numbers on this sheet. The most important one is this one, S14. This is the starting stage, or the liftoff stage, launch stage, whatever. It is when you are still attached to the launch pad, and with this stage you basically launch off. So the thing is, you need to have a TWR bigger than 1. This is a thrust weight ratio. It means how much thrust you can put on, for example, 1 kilo or 1 ton or whatever. And this ratio needs to be bigger than 1. Everything lower than 1 means you have either way not enough thrust or too much weight. Too much thrust is a thing you can handle with adding more engines, but you then have to watch the other numbers as they change with the Kerbal Engineer calculation. I had one configuration where at stage 11, 10, 9, I don't know, there was a huge drop in thrust ratio, thrust weight ratio, and I was basically losing thrust. I was in the 0 point area, 0.678, I don't know. Basically, it was the death of this vehicle to go any further. The configuration was just too inefficient. So I had a lot of testing, and in the end I saw one guy's design. And at least for this one, I thought, okay, why not copy it? It seems to work, so why not test it and copy the basic design idea? And this basic design idea, let's put these away. The basic design idea is adding these tail connectors. I already have some unlocked tail connectors there. They look like this. Wait, I will attach one properly. Yeah, come on. What's wrong? Come on, attach. it's shy. I don't know. Okay. Yeah, these are the tails or tail connectors, which means if you are in the space plane hangar and building a space or generally a plane. And as you remember or already have seen, this is the tail part of Jumbo or the like. Not exactly, you see the way it's shaped, it's not really from a Jumbo or the like. But the general idea is you have, for example, yeah, this part. This is a typical. Somehow I'm not able to get it like I want to. Okay. Okay, this works. Yeah, as you usually see, planes have these angles at the rear side. Yeah, Duna. I'm just a little bit talking to myself, explaining what I did to finally solve my thrust problem. I was in the middle of explaining this. As you see, this is a typical tail of a plane, a regular plane as you know it from the real world. And then you have these tail connectors. It's an extension to as a finish, and you could add like these wings to it. And this is basically the idea. So this is what I did. I used these to attach engines to it. These, and it works. There's a full fuel flow, and they are, I don't know if they are really overheating. I've seen they produce heat, they are getting bright red, but I added some radiator panels to prevent any damage and so on. So I did one test launch yesterday. It worked pretty well, so it was able to lift all the lower stage into orbit. And this is now my problem child. I wanted this to be a little bit efficient, since this is only a stage in I will reload the other I mangled with it just a moment. Duna, 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 Duna. There we go. Okay. Okay, this is basically my ship. This whole stage here, as you see, this will only be able to do orbit around Minmus. And this stage, just a moment, I will remove this. Okay, and this stage will be insertion stage and orbiting around Duna. It shall orbit Duna for a longer time, so my lander, which is currently only this dummy tank, can land initially once, and I wanted to come back the lander and refuel and do a second landing in some other biome. So the thing is, I used this jumbo tank, the full jumbo tank as a dummy, and we will see how this will work out. As I said, I was able to yesterday to get the lower stage, or let's say this full stage, into orbit. And then I did a test burn onto Duna, and the next thing was this portal is okay, but not that okay. Which means I need to switch it, probably, which I haven't tested yet. To Skipper, and there goes my fuel. The alternative is to go a little bit slower. I have chosen the earliest approach possible, which means at day 150 I tried a go, and I did a small mistake, which was I was going for the burn, and the problem with the burn was the the insertion angel was in Kerbin's atmosphere, which meant I was decaying myself. So epic fail, and I stopped this experiment. Now there's this trouble with the engine not having enough power. I need to find a solution with the technology I have at hand. I do not want to do any science farming at the moment. It's just I have to find a solution and see if I'm able to do the full insertion. I'm capable to do it, but it takes a long time, and I need to really plan this out, because yesterday I did it on a whim, and it was a bad idea. So I was more or less hurting myself more than necessary. Phew, 4.2.9. Yeah, and the problem is I currently do not have enough research points to research the mainsail, and this is the main problem that I have. The missing mainsail makes it a lot harder for me to to get the Duna insertion and an easier orbit and so on. So I will leave it like it is. I will do a test run like it is. I know it's capable of doing the orbit, so I will add this to the sub-assemblies. Okay, so just for your information, I used this Jumbo tank as a dummy for my lander, and also the mini lander I still need to design, but I will do this on weekend. This evening or today, whatever you see my time, it's my local time. Germany. It's quite late and I have to work tomorrow, so yeah, I will go for a 1 hour show now, since I already did some time with the introduction. Sorry for that. I hope nobody is sleeping already. Wake up. Anyway, I have saved this sub-assembly and I'm now loading my lander and at the sub-assembly, and then we can go to Duna. Yeah, this is my lander. And yeah, let's add this. It's huge. Oh my God. Ah. Hope my system will not die. Not a matter of graphics power, believe me. Okay, let's see. Where are we standing? This is stage 4. So everything under 4, 3.5, nearly 3.6, with being careful, there should be no prob. Oh, I see there's some clipping. Whatever the reason is. Yeah. Usually these outer tanks are also or were connected like this. Now that I think about it. Okay, but after this, we can directly go. And send this into orbit. I'm just having a proper look if there's everything prepared. So let's go through the checklist. Okay. Yeah, this is bogus, sending this off and this As usual, there's also this. This shouldn't be there. Separator, okay. Okay, Duna X1. Yeah, so let's get this up. Oh, yeah, and there we go. I already forgot something. I do not need to add a pilot. This is important. I do not need Jebediah. What I really need is an engineer and a scientist. Maxi and Mooney. Perfect. Oh, wait. I will. Better ate a girl. Girl. Engineer. Carrie sounds nice. Okay, Carrie and Mooney. Yeah, and I see there's another thing I should check before everything else. Yeah, just as I resumed. Let's see. Yeah, this needs some kind of control. And of course, controls needs batteries. Batteries. The impact is okay. Could be worse. Anyway, solar panels here and there. Yeah, this should do. Crew is changed. Okay, then let's get this into orbit. Oh. Okay, some screenshots. Another thing, I forgot that the insertion stage, and it's also the ejection stage. Yeah, this. Course, somehow we need to dock at some point, not only in this orbit around Duna, but as I already described, I want to go and do some, yeah, I need to do this maneuver to dock the lander and refill it. Okay, yeah, close. This is really close, but I have enough monopropellant then. Okay, this should do. And the RCS is also good for some alignment. What's the date? 120. Oh, okay, this was 125 when I tried to do a first launch. Pressing T, pressing that. Whoa. Awesome. Look at that. Look at that. Wow, this is insane drain. Look at that. Oh no, oh no, I already dropped them while they are not empty. Okay, again. There was a hidden fuel supply, I don't know. okay, let's launch this again. Yeah, I'm not like dead is dead, so I will reload when anything happens. Okay, but I will save this definitely now. Okay, I watched the second, I checked the second, second tank. Okay, it's number 16 for now. Now, yeah, I need to watch this carefully, so I do not miss points of staging. This is a little bit more critical, especially because of the mass and how much fuel is burned. As you see, it's insanely draining. So crazy. Some minor explosions. Okay, there we go. Drop. The next one, nearly. I'm ignoring all the explosions. Okay, I'm quite slowly doing the turn. This needs to be carefully controlled, as far as I have control. Once first I do not... Oh shit. Ah, sorry, sorry. Ah! Okay, this is not how it should have gone. I should have decreased my speed. Doesn't matter. Let's do this again. Okay, just a moment, I will have to pour some drink. Somehow I'm running dry today. It's a ginger ale, by the way. That you think I'm starting to drink within the week? Phew! Oh, feels much better. Hey. Okay, what does Mr. Das Waldes usually say? 3-2-1? Space. So let's copy paste. And now, as you see, these are being drained, they are lighting out, burning out. This is also a good indicator, a visual indicator, if I'm not having a proper look at the numbers. Because somehow I'm always getting distracted by this and that. So, I also cannot ask you to remind me because it's so asynchronous. Okay, at 10k I will start a little decrease in acceleration, so I'm not going supersonic speed or Mach 1, Mach 2 and the like. Time to reduce speed a little bit. Yeah, now the thing is we are getting to the core. And a nice picture. And yeah, as you see we are... Yeah, we are now supersonic speed, at supersonic speed. I will increase the, okay, I will increase the speed now, and we'll slowly go for the so-called gravity turn. Reduce the speed a little bit, we are going quite good. What I can do is go with the prograde marker to increase the speed with the prograde marker. This is a little bit more efficient. And since the way you this craft is going quite slower than other crafts. Oh no! Oh come on! all that scatter. This is glorious. You know, if parts overturning you or are faster than you, and you see like a tank floating in front of you, then you have done something wrong. Something terrible wrong. Oh, sorry for that. Usually, yeah, this is beyond my influence. We are on a such a good run this time. Okay, so as usual, this there's a high degree of randomness. Okay, so let's try again with our Duna mission. Yeah. The effects are quite nice. I'm currently doing some screenshots, so there was nothing wrong with your screen regarding no hood. You can press F2 in-game, then the hood will be removed, and with F1 you do screenshots. If you did not already know. And the screenshots folder is not within your user data, but within your Steam app folder. Yeah, where Kerbal Space Program is located. So, yeah, this will also be my first Duna mission where I used Kerbal Engineer and the calculations of it. The other time I used one Duna mission which I glued together from old scratches and without any calculation tool and the like. I was able to get into Duna orbit, but that's it merrily, so poor Jebediah was trapped there for forever because I also did not want to go for a rescue mission and leave another Kerbal behind. Afterwards I would have or should have opened their village and a town meeting and so on. Or send them cake every now and then. Just to show them that the cake wasn't a lie. Okay, we are at 12k. I will slowly try to turn over. Reduce my speed. Yeah, hard to say. Okay. Now this is getting critical. Last time it this exploded on me. So I'm curious how it's behaving now. What I'm now trying to do is get back the Prograd Maker to 90 degree. You see it's the degree marker is wobbling between 89, 88, 90 and so on. This is because the whole rocket is not that stable. You see it's quite stiff and moving, and yeah, I'm trying to do my best. I'm gonna save, increase speed and drop the last next batch of tanks. Put the speed a little bit down. Okay, I'm nearly in full orbit, so I will go and increase my speed now. I have lots of fuel left. The thing is, for proper orbit, I will go to 100k. I hope this is possible. Let's save, otherwise I can stop anytime. Oh, okay. Yes. Nice. Okay. Let's do a save. It's not the best ballistical route so far. Yeah, there's I think an old ship running around. Okay, 1500. Wow. You see, I'm pressing the key to turn the ship all the time, but it's not that easy to move. Okay, I'm nearly at the marker for the burn. Now, I will do the burn now to have a little bit more control. Otherwise, I have no control at all. Okay, this is getting tight, and it seems I have to. Let's see, S5. Oh, okay. Yeah, it seems I need to rely on my next stage. Last time I did quite a lot better with the orbit. Yeah, there you see. I do not have enough delta V. This is nearly half of what I need or have. Maybe I should have gone lower at a lower orbital alignment, like 80 kilometers or the like. But hard to say for now. Okay. So, let's go with the last batch, and I hope there will be at the end enough fuel left. I calculated for one. Refuel of the lander. Okay, I'm already behind my plan. This portal is just too weak, at least for the amount of mass it has to move. Okay, I will reload. As I said, I'm not ashamed of reloading. I'm doing this a little bit earlier since I have enough thrust to do so now. We'll see how far we can get with this. Yeah, I do not want to increase my height. I want to the altitude. I want to go do the orbital burn. This is quite tricky with the way it is now. Okay, yeah, that's okay, and they are overheating. Finally. Okay, let's redo this. Maybe I overdid it and should have gone to 80 kilometers. This would have been a lot easier to handle. Okay, there's some heat generated. Okay, these are flamed out. Bye. Okay. Let's see how far we can get like this. Oh, I hope these do not shred my Oh, okay, I guess it's better to pull them in. As you see, my periapsis height is in the minus. This means I'm still, this is still within the planet. From some higher zoom level, you can see it increasing. It's some graphical glitch of the engine, or I don't know. At least it gives you always a glimpse of where you are now, more or less. Of course, now we are still quite far away. -220. This means I still need to do 140 extra. This engine is just too weak. If I would have less weight, like without these, maybe, then it would have been more efficient. But currently it's just too much weight, so yeah, I have to see if I can do some yeah, some trade-off with some other engine mounted together, like the big engine cluster you saw on the orbital rocket. Okay, this is not gonna happen. but it certainly does look impressive. Okay, again, not enough thrust. Actually, I did not want to use this stage except for insertion to Duna, but I'm currently forced to, do what I'm doing now. But I think I will. Yeah, leave anyway. I will have some minor modifications. Oh, nope, this is the wrong design. Po-po-po. Duna. Ah, okay, I mixed it up. Duna X1. Okay. Okay. Okay, that's been crazy. Yeah, let's be crazy. because we can. Oh, let's wait. No, this is too crazy if I do this. This will just compromise the stability. I will add further tanks there. Okay, this is hard, but not but it's working. Okay. What? Okay. Okay, let's save, and I need to go and load another save file, it seems, where I have some more money. Oh, this is crazy. Oh, okay, I need to recover this. Yeah. Okay, then, yeah. Problem solved. Thought I was forced to do a reload, which I do not want, nor, yeah. Okay, Mooney. And where are you, girl? Carrie, yeah. Okay. Just glorious. Okay, just a moment. Okay. Yeah, so Yeah, as you see, these outer tanks are more or less improvised. I was testing with adding fuel and watching the delta V changes, so this can be optimized. And this is, yeah, just my let's try prototype. So I guess next time or at the weekend I will remove these and replace them with the orange tanks, and maybe add some of these tanks somewhere here. I don't know, I have to shift these from left to right, right to left, and see how much delta V is generated or wasted. So yeah, I hope this time we get quite as smooth to yeah, this time I will try 80 kilometers. This is enough, and from there I can save and start to any location. The time. Day 125, yeah. Okay, this is where I have recalled somewhere starting. There was some old sheet, I don't know, some spreadsheet with the earliest possible interplanetary transfers. And I remember something with day 49 for Duna, or maybe that was Eve / Moho, one of these. I might be mistaken. I don't know anymore. But the thing is, I tried to, or I really remember that something between day 120 and 150 is a good window for start. The start window calculator, there's some tool online, was stating me something like day 231, 231, because it has the optimal fuel efficient variant, which means I'm, yeah, roughly using 1k, 1.1k to go to Duna, while the approaches now usually need like 1.456 delta V. So well, this is not my problem now. My problem still is getting into a proper orbit and doing proper staging. Not talking and watching the numbers. Okay, I'm going to slow down a little bit and start with turning. Okay, yeah, just as I thought, because of the movement that was still ongoing, me tilting to the east, that was not good. Yeah, okay, now we did it better. I will wait until the prograde marker is on my mark now. and then I will increase my speed again. Oh yeah, I'm already in orbital variant. Phew, that was close. I should really attach some separatrons, but I have not researched them yet. Close. Okay, we are nearly in space. What's the apoapsis? I will try to follow the prograde marker to increase my speed as much as possible, because this will give me some push. Okay, we are now into orbit. I will go to 80 kilometers. And yes, I set the push because I have so much delta V on me. Will decrease the amount needed to do the orbital burn. Which I really should have on my radar. Come on, stop. Okay. Yeah, let's see. I hope I'm not needing more than these 700. Ah, okay. Yeah, the calculation stopped. Doesn't matter to me. Okay, this means I need 74. Come on. Okay, let's turn this off. Going on here. So basically, I should have already burned, but with the way sometimes these damn markers are working, or rather not working, it's always a little bit complicated. Sometimes you can work instantly, but sometimes they are so not working at all. Okay, this time I will go and use the injection stage to go for some. Yeah, we are nearly okay, perfect. Or nearly perfect. Yeah. This should do the trick. This is just pretty slow in regards to yeah, it has pretty low thrust to weight ratio. Oh, this takes ages. This is just crazy. This engine is so slow and doing nothing. Whoa. Now this needs to be reloaded. And I do not feel ashamed about it. I'm not a pro, I'm a casual. and this neat, this whole design thingy, this takes ages on my side, but sometimes I have a real knack for it, sometimes it's yeah, not working as I want to, and then I most usually stop playing the game for some time to rethink my strategies, or I'm just raging. Okay, let's try again. Okay. Phew. Close. We'll do this on the side, because I need to switch the stages, definitely. Oops. I'm actually in overtime. I'm going to burn some retrograde and some retrograde prograde and some horizontal, and I hope this will generate enough delta V for the orbit. We are quite done. Just the push out. I hope this time we are able to do it. Okay. Yeah, there's a small periapsis growing. I should really follow the dotted marker. Ah, oh, this engine is so terrible, at least with the heavy extra weight. If I'd put two or three of these engines on, it would be okay. Okay. 70, 20, 92. I take it. Okay, space center. I will warp to day 100 and fifty. Yeah. Okay, this is still steep, not 44-45 degrees, but I want to try another approach. And what I also want to try is the separator. I have never used any separators yet, and okay, there, this is also not the best staging. Okay, yeah, then. Let's try. Ah, yes, nice, okay. Boing. Okay. Yeah, this is the typical Apollo maneuver. Before I do anything wrong, I will deactivate these two engines. Or rather, shut them down. Okay. Ah, yeah, this is. Okay. So it's handled like this. We need some energy for these probe cores. We'll hope these solar panels will not drop my tanks. So let's wait and see what happens. Okay, picture time. Oh, what do we have there? It's a separator floating in space. Oh, I think I forgot. Oh, nice. That's so sweet. Okay. I will just remove these for now. So, do now. Set is started. Okay, now comes. Ah, okay, this is the wrong direction. Yeah, this is prograding. Ah, yes, okay. Yeah, as I said, this is testing. There can be encounters, there cannot be encounters. We'll have to see what happens. Okay. Okay. So we do not have any approach like this. Again, from like here. Oh wow, okay, this might be a possible encounter. 1.4. Let's see. Okay, that was
1.6 yeah, increasing it to 1.6. Let's have a look. Okay, the trick is you need to activate the node after you centered on Duna, and then you will see where you're going to approach Duna. Okay. This means I need to go like this. Okay, 1.6. This will take ages. With the current way my especially with my engine. Will also look funny because I do not know if I start burning here if it will not shift my my complete orbit to into atmosphere. That was what happened yesterday or on Tuesday. Ah, come on, don't oversteer this. Okay, let's get some help from RCS. Okay, I should have burned. Well, some minutes ago already with this engine. The way I'm pointing. I guess there's still the separator floating around. Okay. Okay, there was still the control from not working. Okay, yeah, as I said, I should have already burned. The burn will take 9 minutes. Oh my God. Poor. Let's do this. Oh yeah, it's a little bit wobbly now. Okay. Whoa, it's even 15 minutes. Whoa. I will just let it run like this and see what happens. So far it's not like last time. Last time I was pointing in this direction, so onto the planet, and that was pulling my my orbit into atmosphere. So it was increasing the orbit, but sadly through the atmosphere, so it was ineffective and useless. This is, yeah, as I said, this is just my prototype run. With Kerbals. Yeah, sometimes it's a little bit tricky and the wobble takes over. I hope this will stabilize. Ah, come on. Ah, no, no, no. No! I hate these physics. Why? Why? This is just crazy. I don't know why you have these this wobble in the docking ports. At least in my game, it's always the same. You are interested, you can watch my official video where I build one space station at Minmus, and it's the same. It's going into total wobble for no reason. boy. Yoing. So useless. Guess I will. Nope, not decouple. Disable. Yeah. I guess this will already help a little bit. Nope, does not. Come on, what? I don't understand why this is wobbling. This is... There is no reason, and I do not understand why the clamps are doing this. What a waste of fuel and time. When I'm ready with the burn, it will not be the same as predicted. It will be something completely different. This is just idle. Getting my encounter. So on. Watch this. Boy, yoing. Yeah, and I'm already steering in some other direction and forcing my progress vector somewhere completely different. This is useless. If I had known this beforehand, I don't know. Actually, I do not know what to do against this. Because I have to redock somehow. Because this is my return vehicle. When I'm leaving Duna for the second time, this lower stage part will be dropped or kept in orbit, whatever, and only the upper module part with the two capsules will stay on the main ship and return. Man, it's like trying to douse a fire, and you all you do is point your hose at the neighboring houses, but not into the fire at all. So I'm burning like crazy, not getting myself aligned to target marker. You know, it's getting better with less gimbal on the engine. It's just so crazy. I'm afraid that it will be really, really off target. Okay, wow, this actually helped. Whatever the reason now is, I don't know. But I guess I have wasted a lot of Delta V just for this stupid maneuver. Okay, oh, okay, this was whatever. Oh, okay, this was a deorbit. And since we are off course, anyway, I need to do a correction burn sometime. Well, if I'd known that, I would reload. Okay, I will leave this ship as it is. Reduce the gimbal now to be a little bit smarter. What day do we have? 51, okay. Luna. Oh, wow. Come on. Stupid note. This is what I hope they fix in time, because this is pretty annoying. We only have the interface nodes. In the stock game, I tried to add this, what's it called, precise node, but it's currently not compatible, at least it's indicated. I'll have to check on that. Okay, the encounter is lost. Okay, there it is again. these notes are useless. Okay, again, let's reduce gimbal here. This should produce enough power for both ships for now. My note? Why? Okay, we are already lost it. Okay. Okay, this might be interesting. I will save this and see what is going to happen. I do my burn. But it looks like it will be like the last time. It's like I'm going straight through the planet. Kerbin. Yeah. No, not the moon. Okay, it seems I'm again in this strange trajectory, which means when I'm out of luck, I will burn in the atmosphere already. Yeah, you see, I'm here and I'm pressing into this direction, but this will totally kill my orbit. There's no way I can glitch away with this. Okay, these are turning hot for whatever reason again. Oh, I hope my game is not crashing. Oh, these are already red. Why? Okay, I will disable this. Ah, okay. Now this explains it. I did not check my altitude. Okay. So. Is decreasing or not? We will see. On the other hand, my panels will die. Thank you. my apoapsis is somehow still rising. So I'm really doing a shave. So this is slowly rising. Okay. This is insane. Funny thing is that, okay, I have no control up here. There's no control. Forget about it. Leave. I'm fed up with it. Okay, that's it for my do not try. Again, I guess I will have to add the skipper to the upper part to have enough delta V or slash thrust to make a proper getaway. And I have to do some other alterations and changes, but this weekend. Yeah, okay, I will cut it from here. Thank you for tuning in, and if you are interested in what I'm doing, I'm just gaming for fun, nothing commercial, it's just for fun. So yeah, you can follow me on Twitch, YouTube, and on Twitter. Twitter especially, since I usually announce when I'm going to stream. So I would appreciate also Twitter and yeah, Twitter follows. So thank you very much, and yeah, have a nice evening and good night.